26th. It's Thursday. Yesterday was Christmas. So, you know, I had a great day. Got to see some family, friends, all that good stuff. And the really cool part about today is I'm actually getting out for the first time in the late season here in 2019. I'm hunting in the same spot that I hunted last year, where I had a couple encounters with the buck and call prospect. And this year, he's definitely one that I'd really like to take. I've been trying to hunt him, you know, when I can. And today being the day after Christmas, I had work today, but I was able to get off work early. Last year, it was a cut bean field with a food plot right behind me. This year, it's a food plot, same stuff, brassica, turnips, radishes, a great late season plot with a cut cornfield in front of me. What happens is these deer like to stage in the food plot. They like to get set up in the food plot, and then they'll come out to the corn. And that's what we saw last year with the beans. I mean, the beans were just fire last year. They brought in so many deer. We got a good wind tonight. There's overcast, low winds. So another three does stepped down the food plot. This food plot runs northwest of me, and the wind's out of the west, northwest, so it's a great wind for this evening. The only thing that's going to be bad is if they get so comfortable and they make their way all the way to the cornfield and get downwind of me before the bucks come out. I just got done saying that I need to hope the bucks show up before the does make their way to me and get downwind of me. And that first buck just stepped out. Yeah, I don't know which one it is yet. Yep, that's the big eight. That's the big 8 point. Yeah, he's a nice buck. We've had two encounters with him already this year. Once with Easton, the very first weekend of the youth season. And then we had an encounter with him in the middle of October. I think he was the split G2 buck from last. Oh, here comes another buck. I just got old prospects thinking the same thing. That's really encouraging because he's not a young deer. I do think he's 4.5. Doesn't get dark for an hour and 45 minutes and we have one of the more mature bucks already out in the field feeding. That is an outstanding sign. Outstanding. The 10 deer that were in the food plot are making their way up the food plot. Deer that worked their way from the food plot back here, and they're coming up this way. They all got out here, and then they spooked. They got my wind. So even though those deer spooked, there's still deer out in the field, and we've got about an hour till it gets dark, so you can't be too disappointed, and you know, that's just hunting. second season this year, I decided to set up on turnips tonight on the inner field. We're on the same property that we were running yesterday. I'm on the box we call Prospect. And I figured I'd try the turnip field back here because we were seeing deer and turnips yesterday, and I figured maybe Prospect would be back here.
My 10 point, it was the last one that came out of the field. I looked at it, I saw this one right, I saw this right here, and I knew that, I was like, I'm gonna take it. And then I shot it, and when I shot, I saw it jump, and then all the deer in the field just start spreading. And I'm like, dude, I don't know if I got it. And Chris is like, he goes, it crossed the road, but he goes, I think it did. And then we were walking over, I didn't see anything, and then Chris just said, hey, here it is. I aimed right there and hit right there, so.
Yeah, the old smoke pole, I'm not used to that, PA. You put the snack down on it, that's for sure. How far out of the shot was it?
125, damn. There were four with them, there were four bucks with them. I mean, they were small, but this one.
He was the last one.
He was the last one, and I mean, you could really tell the difference.
Yeah, that's a beautiful buck. I can't believe that. That's really cool.
I can't do it on the first day, man.
You probably can go back to all your buddies. Man, Iowa is the place to be.
Yeah,
it's so
all
easy.
Over the place.
You wouldn't believe it. It took me 3 hours. You get to tell everybody that you're just that good of a hunter.
I was just worried because he's like, it went down, and he's like, you're going to be coming over cameras and stuff. I'm just like, oh, man. I go, he comes over the camera, we're not, I missed it, and then it's been documented, I missed the deer.
No, that's happened to me.
So in the state of Iowa, Tom, you're not permitted to move them without a tag. So before we load them, we got to make sure we have a tag on there.
I'm getting my tag right
there.
There
it is, baby.
Where did he come from?
Right. I'm not so sure. He came from behind the trees, but I think he came from across the road.
No, he had to have.
That's still.
Hey, man, that's awesome. The coolest part about this buck is this is the same buck that I'd called Chicken. I didn't even realize Chicken was alive in 2019 when Tom killed him. But Chicken was a buck that we had a very, very infrequent history with. In 2017, our buddy found his match set 2 miles north of where he was shot. And then in 2018, I knew he was in the area because I would get trail cam pictures of him on this same food source, but it would only be at night. So when I would go and hunt the area, I would always see him across the road feeding on another food source. Well, in 2019, the Chicken finally crossed the road and Tom put the smack down on him.
Betcha. Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
Setting up on the other end of that field where we saw him 2 days ago. Prospect stepped out right there and worked his way to 100 yards last time. So we're gonna hope that he does the same thing because it's gonna be a chip shot if he does.
Alright guys, it's January 3rd, 2020, my first hunt of 2020, and I'm hoping to start the year off on a high note. The story doesn't change, only the year does, but what I'm doing tonight is I'm going to that tower blind that we hunted last weekend when I saw Prospect. You know, we've been playing this game of cat and mouse all year, back in the youth season with Easton. We've even played it a couple times here in the late season. Relative to the weather that we've had for the late season this year, the weather tonight's really, really good. We got a good wind for this evening. This tower blind sits on the south end of the field, and the field runs north-south, so basically just blown off to the west. And I think what he's doing, he's coming from the west and he's going east. We just gotta hope he comes close enough to the tower blind. So I gotta get quiet because we're getting closer now.
pressure's on. Today is Thursday, January 9th, and tomorrow, Friday, January 10th, is the last day to hunt here in Iowa for the 2019/2020 season. I pulled an all-nighter last night, went into work early, got my 10-hour shift in, checked the cameras, checked the very first camera, and prospect was out in an area that I thought he would be last night at 5 o'clock. It's about 3 o'clock now. On the last day of the season, what might have been the most miserable hunt of the season, being that it rained and then it froze, I wasn't able to film what I saw, but I only ended up seeing two does. And that's going to conclude the 2019 deer hunting videos. It was a long year, it was a hard year. However, we did end up finding one of prospect sheds in February 2020. Oh, yeah. I can tell you this, with 2020 we have some awesome videos to come. And if you enjoy these videos, please make sure to subscribe. We got shed hunting coming up. And then the 2020 videos will be dropping really soon, so stay tuned.
There it is. That's one of his sides. So we still got about an hour left of sunlight left. What a great way to end the day. We just found two sheds within 30 minutes, and prospect's one of them, so the day is made.